Yes, I'm here just outside of Tamworth in the heart of what's called the Golden Triangle, the Wheat Belt. This is the food bowl of northern New South Wales. And while there have been a lot of hard luck stories about the drought, farmers are fighting back. These people are not helpless. These people have been planning for this. They know what they have to do. And when something like this happens, a whole bunch of gears kick in. And I'm about to introduce you to the guy who makes things happen. This is the man who gets hay from all over the country, finds it wherever he can get it, and then brings it and delivers it to the people on the land who need it. Have a look. Cal, so you bring in hay from all over the country and distribute it to the farms around here. What is involved and how do you do it?
So, Joe, basically we've never had to deal in big stuff like that. We leave that to other resellers. About 3-4 months ago, we started getting the call where our normal hay supplements just weren't lasting. So we started to bring in stuff from South Australia. We got onto a few growers just through relationships that we have in the industry. And then we got on to the right people carting the product for us, which is Bordertown Haulage in Bordertown. So yeah, those guys are bringing it up. And then from there, we're distributing out through to our other branches.
Have you ever seen demand like this before? You say you've never had to call in quantities like this in the past.
No, not really. We've never dealt in the big stuff. We've always left that to other people in town. McDonald Brothers do a fantastic job out there, but we've just had to make our hay supplies that we had from our local growers last through this period. We don't look to profit on a drought. And I can say that to you honestly. I think most resellers or majority of resellers aren't looking to, you know, profit on these times. Our customers need to be supported through this period so that when it turns, we're going to be here and we'll expect those customers that we can continue our relationship on. If there was one good thing about this drought, it's the amount of realisation that hopefully people in the city will see of the amount of work and effort and what actually goes in that supply chain, put that food on their plates. I'm looking forward
to seeing the smile. How much hay have you actually brought in?
All up, it's about 10,000 tonne in produce we've done.
And prior to this, you weren't actually bringing any of these big bales in?
Well, in a good season, we don't need to.
So this is where the hay ends up here on Mark Walters' farm. And Mark, this is the first time you've ever had to bring in hay from outside.
It is, Joe, yeah. We had a supply for about 5 months and we're coming to the end of that. I mean, we obviously don't want to run out of that, so we want to have a little bit up our sleeves. It's exceptional circumstances. It's difficult for everybody. We've been through other droughts before, but this surpasses all of them. To explain it to people who aren't really affiliated with the land, you think, well, how could you explain it? And I think it's like an ancient sailor out on the ocean and you're looking for land. You've got a boat full of food and water, but you don't see land and
never know if it's even going to come over the horizon.
No, that's it. You don't know how many days you've got to go.